Hi everybody, this is Dr. Ladd McNamara. We're going to spend some time and talk about oxidative stress, because that is a big issue with everyone. As a matter of fact, there's a little saying that I created, and it's a kind of a take on the saying where you say the love of money is the root of all evil. Well, oxidative stress is the root of all disease. Pretty close anyway. And as you're taking your quality supplements, particularly your antioxidants, your vitamin antioxidants and minerals, because minerals are very important as well, you need to understand a little bit about it. So let's review a little bit of that. So this is a little overview, and I'm going to have a little fun with it. And that is, first of all, the oxidation is the stealing of electrons to create free radicals. So that's kind of what it is, at least on a biochemical level. But really, as you try to understand it, is that oxidative stress in the body, which is the free radical damage of it, which we all have some of that in our body all the time, and we have it at different times. The oxidative stress can damage our DNA and lead to cancer, can damage LDL cholesterol and lead to heart disease and stroke, and can damage our even our elastin in our skin and lead to wrinkling, and it can damage our mitochondria, which are cells within a cell that create ATP, the energy molecules. The mitochondria are extremely important to life. As a matter of fact, that's kind of like a source of life for our cells, for our body. Without mitochondria creating ATP, you couldn't do anything. And oxidative stress to the mitochondria is a very big problem, leading to fatigue and not being able to create any additional proteins, et cetera. So one thing I did mention, I said that LDL cholesterol, the oxidative stress to the LDL cholesterol is a big problem. I want to demonstrate this in my lectures as I travel. I used to show some, use a balloon to represent LDL cholesterol. Now the balloon is floating around like in the bloodstream, like an LDL cholesterol molecule. And what happens is that it gets oxidized. Now LDL cholesterol does not stick to your arterial walls unless it's oxidized. Now, LDL cholesterol comes along and it gets oxidized. Now, if I rub this balloon on my shirt like this, it steals electrons. See, this is statically charging, it's stealing electrons. And once you steal electrons, it sticks to the walls. And the LDL cholesterol will stick to your arterial walls if it's not oxidized. But if it's not oxidized, it won't stick. Now, HDL cholesterol stands for high density LDL cholesterol. The high density means it's small and compact, and no matter how much you rub it, there's not enough surface area on there to get it oxidized. It won't stick in their little wily characters, and they don't stick at all. So the cholesterol, though, you know, it can get oxidized very easily, and it just sticks right away. Now, if you're taking antioxidants, the antioxidants kind of go on and they protect, they neutralize the free radicals, and they protect the LDL cholesterol, so therefore, you know, they don't stick, they'll just kind of float right through. So only the oxidized LDL cholesterol stick and form plaque, arteriosclerosis, heart disease, stroke. So that's key to understand. So what increases the oxidative stress in your body? Well, smoking does, of course, increase cortisol levels. Increased cortisol levels, which be like increasing stress and decreasing sleep. So if you're not getting enough sleep, then that will increase your cortisol levels. Also, fried foods will do that, and fatty foods, particularly trans fats. Now, there are good fats like fish oil and coconut oil, and there are bad fats and sugar. Sugar is really bad, especially high sugar levels, high glycemic ones that spike your sugar levels up rapidly. And when you spike your sugar levels up rapidly, that creates tremendous amounts of free radicals, and it oxidizes LDL cholesterol. And that's why diabetes leads to atherosclerosis so rapidly and causes all sorts of problems, including stroke and dementia and kidney disease and peripheral neuropathy, et cetera. So the point is that you want to avoid oxidative stress and avoid the things that will cause it. Now, the good news is that antioxidants, they donate electrons and they neutralize free radicals. And obviously by nature of that. Now, one thing is that you're familiar with oxidation and oxidative stress and the fact that metal rusts. You've seen bananas go from yellow or green, actually, and they go from green to yellow, and then exposed to the air, the oxygen, they'll eventually go to brown and then black, and they'll spoil. That's oxidative damage. If there's no oxygen, they're not exposed to oxygen, then they will never rot. So if you put bananas in a vacuum, they can be preserved forever because there's no oxidative damage to rot them. Take a rubber band, put it out on the street. You've seen rubber bands from a newspaper out on the driveway, and the sun hits them, and the rubber band will then get all dried and just wrinkling, cracked. And then if you try to stretch the rubber band, bam, it just snaps because it loses all of its elasticity. Well, that's what the sun can do to your skin as well, because the UV light can damage through oxidative damage, free radical damage to your skin and elastin. It will make it, you know, wrinkled, and so your elastin doesn't have the elasticity anymore. Your arterial walls, it has elastin molecules in your arterial walls to be able to expand with your blood pressure, boom, 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 et cetera. So, and when it gets dried and loses its elasticity as well, it can rupture. So that's a big problem. And lastly, because this is going to be short, is that there are two different main types of antioxidants. There's exogenous antioxidants, where we get from our food and supplements. Exo, from outside, genesis, created from outside. And then endogenous, the ones that are generated from inside our body. So endogenous, those are the enzymes, superoxide dismutase, catalase, glutathione, etc. Those are the ones. And the thing is that these endogenous enzymatic antioxidants, they require minerals, trace minerals. So it's very important to get our trace minerals as well. So good quality, you know, the good quality one to be on, vitamin, mineral, antioxidant supplement is critical. And what's really important is with intelligence technology, the intelligence is that it's a complex of micronutrients that stimulate the body with the cell signaling to the DNA to stimulate for the creation of more endogenous antioxidant enzymes to neutralize the free radical stress. So that's very key. And it generates more mitochondria for more ATP, the energy molecules. Well, the bottom line is this. In summary, health. You can more likely to enjoy long-term health if your long-term antioxidant status is greater than your oxidative status. That's it in a nutshell. So go out there, be healthy, enjoy, have a good day. Bye-bye.